Good morning, Bishop Gorman.
I'm Alex Porterfield.
And I'm Colton Castro. And I bet you're so happy to be back in the classroom on this marvelous Monday morning.
And while we know that this could possibly be the best week ever, we must take a sobering moment to remember a day that was anything but that. The most tragic day in the history of our nation.
10 years ago yesterday, a small group of men killed 3,000 innocent people.
It forever changed the way we think, the way we travel, the way we look at each other, and the way we look at the world.
Please stand for the prayer and the pledge.
Let us remember that we are in God's holy presence. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, we know that you were with us 10 years ago in New York, Washington, D.C., and Shanksville. You held out your arms and opened the gates of heaven to thousands of good people who left behind so many that they loved. Lord, heal all those who were crushed and broken on that day. May they come to experience your presence and know your peace. Thank you for the heroes who gave so much on September 11, 2001. Help us to remember their courage and to follow their examples. Help us too to remember the spirit that united our country and indeed the whole world at that time. And give us the grace to always try to focus on that which unites us as opposed to that which divides us. We pray that you, Lord, will help us to go on living for truth, firm in our hope of your salvation. May we live for you, and by doing so, be an example to our friends, our family, and the rest of the world. Glory be to God in all things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Get ready for an awesome day, Gorman, because BGTV is coming at you in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This could possibly be the best day ever. And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be a million and six times better. So make every minute count above your bed and seize the day. And let's make sure that in every single possible way.
Good morning, Bishop Gorman.
I'm Danielle Harris.
And I'm Paul Ward, and
this is BGTV.
We all know about the tremendous acts of bravery that occurred on this week in 2001, but also on this week in 1963, 20 African-American students in Alabama also furthered the cause of liberty when they risked angry protesters to attend all-white schools.
And on a lighter note, Hong Kong Disneyland opened on this day in 2005.
Good news! If you're planning a trip to our Disneyland, you could technically squeeze it in the middle of this week. This Wednesday is an in-service day, and dismissal will be at 11:30.
Freshman of the Week. No, it is not a new entree from Chartwell's. Special congratulations to our first winners of the new year, Blossom Hamika and Matthew McCarthy. These two students were nominated by three different teachers, and they've only been in school for 2 weeks. Great job, Blossom and Matthew.
The Creative Writing Club still has some openings for some creative writers. If you're interested, please meet our newly published author, Mrs. McGeckeran, in room 203 at 6:30 any morning. And while you're at it, maybe you can help us write a more entertaining newscast.
Mitebox returns tomorrow, so bring in a spare buck. And don't forget, you can also bring in a catchy Mitebox quote that may possibly be one of the winners this year.
But if just giving money to Mitebox isn't enough for you, maybe you'd like to have a say in how the Mitebox money will be spent. If so, go to Campus Ministry and pick up an application for the Matthew 25 board.
Best Buddies Club. There is an informational meeting tomorrow at 2 o'clock p.m. in the lecture hall.
Our fall sports teams are starting to kick it into high gear. For more on sports, here's Kellie Stewart. Kellie?
Hey everyone, and welcome to another week of BG Sports. This past Friday night, your Gorman Gales posted their second straight shutout, this time against Durango, 49-0. Running back Shaquille Powell rushed for three touchdowns and caught three more from quarterback Anu Solomon. Jameer Tillman had seven receptions and a touchdown. Congratulations, gentlemen, and remember to come out and support our Gales this Friday when they play Clark right here at Fertitta Field. I'm Kellie Stewart, and that's it for sports.
Thanks, Kellie. That's all for us this week. I'm Danielle Harris.
And I'm Paul Ward, and this is BGTV.
From the mountains to the prairies.